Good morning, you guys. So the energy for today is a lot of celebration, a lot of happiness. You guys might be getting good news or just enjoying time with family right now. So that's awesome. I'm gonna pull for three messages and you guys decide which one resonates with you. You might get something from all of the messages. You might get nothing from any of the messages. Just take what resonates, leave what doesn't. We all have masculine and feminine energy, so don't feel any type of way if I say he or she. And I do this for the highest good and the highest healing of those who need to hear the messages the most, okay? So if the messages are repetitive, I have no control over that. I just read what Spirit gives me to read. I try to use different decks to see if I can get different messages. Sometimes it works, sometimes it's the same shit. It is what it is. But yeah. Let's go ahead and start. Oh, and I noticed that you guys have been trying to hit me on Messenger. I do not have Messenger. I download it every few months to see what messages I have on there from people I know. But aside from that, like, I just don't be on there. So if you want to get in contact with me or if you want a reading, you can drop a comment or you can send me an email. And I even think my number is on my page somewhere that you can send me a text message if that's easier. But yeah, I'm going to start now. So with the first message we have here is coming into balance, and that's confirmed twice. So there's a lot of just balancing out of the energies, which would be the masculine and the feminine energies, but also balancing the dark and light aspects of yourself, and that's what's coming in right now, all right? And just try to see what it is that you're neglecting, you know, whatever you're neglecting something about yourself, or you're neglecting some type of like a tradition or something that maybe you need to go back to that you haven't been to or you haven't been doing, okay? You know, like if you haven't been doing your yoga or your meditation practices or things like that, you probably need to go back to that soon, okay? Now, there's some type of fear that you have that's keeping you stuck, okay? That's where your limitations begin. The more fear that you have, the more you're limiting yourself, and that's what they're showing me right now. It's like whatever it is that you're trying to go after or you're reaching for, you're like, it's in your face and it's there, but you're like, you're afraid to reach out and grab it, or you're afraid to move closer to it. Liz, buenos días, ¿cómo está? So yeah, you have some limitation, and again, you guys are getting messages, okay, whether they're in your dreams, or if you're driving down the road, you're watching TV, you're scrolling through your timeline, you guys are getting messages. It's important for you to pay attention to these messages, okay, because they're going to help you to build whatever it is you're trying to build, especially if you're asking your guides for information or questions or clarity, and you're not fully in tune when you're awake. When you're asleep, they'll deliver those messages to you. So pay attention to your dreams and write them down as soon as you wake up, so that way you have that and you can go back to it and be like, oh, this is what this dream meant, or this is what this piece of it meant. Because that's usually how it works for me, at least. You know, I'm not sure about other people, but write them down, because there's messages in those. You just have to sit with it and, you know, kind of decipher your dream. Let's see, whatever structures are being formed right now, it looks like you have to go through a tower moment or some form of destruction, okay? Because somebody here feels foolish for walking away. You know, whether the situation was stagnant, or maybe you were stagnant, or it's taking you a long time to walk away from the situation. Somebody either feels foolish that they walked away from the situation, or they feel foolish for taking so long to walk away from the situation. However it resonates for you, but all I see is someone that just feels real stupid right now, okay? And again, it's just, there was a stuck energy, okay? Like, I have stuck twice, so that's being confirmed. Like, there is no movement, and it's like there's no action, no anything that was being taken. So maybe you're stuck right now, and there's things that you need to purge and you need to walk away from, and maybe you're starting to feel stupid because you haven't done that. Okay, and others of you do feel stupid because you did walk away and it was a stupid mistake that you made, and now you feel like you're stuck and there's nowhere for you to go and you don't know what it is that you need to do next. Okay, so take it how it resonates. You know what decisions you've made recently. But yeah, if you're dealing with somebody, let me see. if you're dealing with somebody that you feel drained by after you're talking to them or dealing with them, that's not a person for you, okay? They're just draining your energy. It's like an energy vampire, okay? They will suck the life out of you when they're around you because that's what they feed off of. They feed off of your energy. So be careful with that, all right? It's important for you to not allow this. Have your boundaries, set up your protections, do energetic cord cuttings. You have to do these things to protect yourself from these types of energies, okay? And whoever it is that you're currently talking to, be careful. Because whatever it is that they're showing you, they're just trying to impress you. So they might be embellishing a little bit here and a little bit there, maybe making them seem a little bit better than what they truly are, okay? Whatever is going on, be careful with whoever this is. And somebody might have a secret account, like another account, so that they can spy or that they can do other things, maybe talk to other women, other men, be on sexual sites, things like that, okay? But it's like, I don't know, it's some type of deceptive behavior on the internet that they're doing, all right? So you decide what it is, you know what you have going on, and like I said, if you're not certain, don't just assume shit, but somebody here is doing extra shit. Now, there's something here that, all right, there's some type of anxiety, okay, some type of fear or like something, excuse me, there's something going on in regards to probably trying to get pregnant or trying to conceive a child. It has something to do with children, okay, and it's like somebody really wants, so it's like maybe there's a, you have either a custody battle going on and you're like obsessed with winning your kids, or you're really obsessed with becoming pregnant. There's something that has to do with this child situation here, okay? And possibly it can even go as far as you being obsessed with someone from your past or someone from your childhood that you know, or they give you some type of anxiety, all right? Whatever that is, but there is air energy is coming out here. So we have Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, and then Libra is confirmed. So if you have any of those signs in any of your placements, okay, that's what's coming out here. So whatever this is, and again, you might just have something going on with kids right now, and it's something that really is has you in your feelings or has you really anxious about it. But there is going to either be some type of communication or some type of travel that's going to be coming through, okay? Some type of something's coming out. All right, whatever it is, there's some type of movement because it's the Eight of Wands. So it's either communication or you're traveling. Something's going to happen quickly. But whatever it is, you know, I know for Libra energy, we have a tendency of being indecisive, you know, with a lot of things because we like to weigh the pros and cons and like analyze every possible outcome. And it's good and bad, but it'll keep you in a place for a long time of, hey, I don't know what to do, you know? So if you're dealing with a Libra, if they do finally make a decision and they decide that you are that person, or they have a solid decision, believe them, because it takes them forever to make a fucking decision. I know. So if I'm telling you I'm 100% sure, that is probably the most surest thing I am of my whole life. So take it like that. But yeah, you know, whatever it is, some of you might have like a public appearance, or you might be online or something like that. You know, whatever it is, it's just you have a, that's who you are, okay? And you might be a person that's full of love and very balanced, okay? And just kind of just try to find peace, all right? And that's typically a trait. Libra tries to just keep the peace between people. But whatever it is, the communication you're going to get is to bring about some type of truce or some type of clarity. Now, if you're dealing with somebody that, there's someone that is getting signs, all right, whether it's you or the other person, it's like they're getting signs, and the signs can be anything. Like, literally, it could be as far as you keep seeing their fucking names everywhere, you keep seeing the numbers, or you're having a thought and the same number pops up, you're seeing the same animals. They keep seeing things that remind them of you, okay? Whatever it is, it's like it's nonstop. It's like constant, because if they're in a stagnant place, or they're in a place of disbelief, or they're like trying to make a decision, they're just getting slammed with things left and right, Okay, there's nothing they can do about it. So if you've been asking questions and spirit's been giving you the answers and you haven't been listening, now they're bombarding you with it, like, this is your person, this is where you need to go, this is what you need to do. So if you've been ignoring it, stop ignoring it, because it's only going to get more intense until you get to where the fuck you're meant to go. There's really only so many ways you can go about that. Now, they want you to have a plan, whatever it is you have going on, whether it's business or in your personal life, whatever you're going towards, okay? Everything doesn't always go the way we plan. Everybody in the world should know this. You know, we can plan for everything, but we have to really be like, how likely is it that it's just going to be smooth sailing, you know? A lot of times we have setbacks or things that just don't work out. So try to plan for setbacks, you know, try to cover as much area as you can when you're planning, you know, just, okay, if everything goes good, great. But if this goes wrong, then we have a plan B, plan C, plan D, however many plans you need for a backup, okay? So don't let these setbacks drain you. Don't let them make you worried and anxious. Just allow them to be what they are and keep moving, okay? Everything's happening the way it's meant to happen. And everything usually has a way of falling into place. So don't look at things as they're separate. Look at it as they're all connected when you're dealing with this. And some of you need to find people to collaborate with, whether it is business or it is just friendships. If you're dealing with things, you know, find people to talk to and collaborate with them, all right? And others of you, if you, you need to learn how to sell stuff, you know, and it's just... maybe you're starting an online business, or you actually do sales, or you want to start selling your work, whatever it is that you do. All right. So, because, you know, that's also an exchange of energy. So you have to learn how to do this and embrace it, because that's really what it is. You know, I know I'm a person that is like, I know what it is to be flat broke and not have shit, but also need some help and guidance. And, you know, so I try to, it's hard for me to sit there and be like, oh, well, I need this much money from you for these services, because it's like I said, I've been broke and I just dead ass needed help. So, you know, I try to figure it out. This is the best thing I could do. I don't know. I just try to be like, as you know, if I know you're on a budget and you work with me, you talk to me, then I'll try to work with you. That's really what it is. But again, balance is coming out here again. So you guys really, 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 you're finding a balance now. It's like you're awakening. You're realizing, like, you're the one that's kept your life like this. You're the one that's kept yourself stuck. You're the one that's allowed all of these things to transpire. And only you can change it, all right? So take the time that you need to relax, you know, and have fun, enjoy life. Just don't OD with it or with the vices, whatever it is that you do. And make sure you have boundaries, especially if you are, you know, working on selling or collaborating. Have a set time every day, like, okay, at this time I'm done with business and it's just family time or whatever, okay? Because they're saying you need time to just be and have fun and, you know, just be more childlike with the things that are going on, because they have this curiosity and this sense of, I'm ready for the next adventure. What else can we do? And if you guys are dealing with somebody, one of you might feel like it wasn't a mutual thing or it was unrequited, but it's not showing me that that's what it is. It's just like, maybe that's what one of you is feeling inside. But you guys need to get to know each other, you know, have conversations, figure out what needs to be healed, what doesn't need to be healed, like what work they have done on themselves, you know, things like that. Like, just kind of go through these things, because some of you might end up in a higher level of a commitment, you know. So if you guys are just friends now, then maybe you'll start dating. If you guys are dating, then you probably get engaged and so on and so forth. But don't feel like whatever it is, if you felt like it wasn't mutual, excuse me. All right, so you'll know. But all right, when you speak truth, regardless of how hard it is, everything has a way of working itself out, okay? So when you're avoiding the tower moment, or you're avoiding speaking the truth and things like that, then it's just, you're basically delaying the inevitable. And maybe you're doing it because you don't want to hurt somebody else's feelings or make somebody feel bad. But you also have to understand if you have spoken the truth and your truth is being discarded or ignored as if you spoke nothing, you have to stand up for yourself. You have to do what's best for you, okay? You can't just allow someone to just say, fuck your feelings, that's not what I want, so we're gonna keep doing this, you know? Because if you allow it, that's what's gonna keep happening. You have to stop it, okay? And try to see the love in everything. You know, because you know what's best for you. You're the only person that knows what's best for you. Okay, and like I said, a lot of this is you finding the healing, you know, doing the work and getting into balance with yourself. And that's a very good thing. You know, you guys are making progress in this. So just try to see the good in all people. And I know sometimes it's hard because humans are not good fucking people. There's just some shitty ass humans in the world. But try to see the best, okay? I know it's hard sometimes, but really, you know, whatever it is, you are going to end up on top. You're going to have a solid foundation, so just be open to working with other people with whatever you have going on. Don't take it I can do it all by myself. Hi, Jennifer. Good morning. How's your day going so far? Now, that was the first reading. I'm going on to the second one. So for this one here, they're showing me like a lot of celebrations, a lot of parties, maybe family time, hanging out, things like that. You know, maybe you guys are just drinking, going to bars, whatever it is, because they're just showing me a lot of alcohol and a lot of people. So I'm taking it as just celebrations. But it's important, like at this moment in time, there's a feminine energy that has to... the word I'm looking for. I can't find the word I'm looking for, but it's like, watch what you're projecting. Not so bad. I've been up, I don't know, I'd be waking up at like 4 o'clock in the morning, so I'd be amped and ready to go. Hi, Ekno, how you doing? But yeah, this feminine energy, there's something about right now what you're doing, whatever it is you're projecting onto other people. You know, there's has something to do with that. Let me see what else we get here. Yeah, so you may be raising your vibration, and there's some karmic energy here that has to do with the 3D. And maybe you feel like you're guarded against this person or this situation. And again, damn it. All right, so we have like... Every time I get kid, it's just, I take it as it's either somebody from your past, somebody you know from childhood, or someone that acts very childlike, like they act very young. I know, Jennifer, I don't have control over it. It's like they come invade my dreams, and then after they're done invading my dreams, they make me wake up, and I'm like, I need rest. Can't win. I just be like, all right, whatever, what do you want me to do? But whatever it is with this karmic energy... I'm gonna have to clarify this a little bit. My karmic partner here. Okay, so someone might be in denial that someone is their karmic. Like you're not believing that your karmic partner is your karmic partner. Okay, and it looks like you guys may even be getting messages about this person in your dreams and maybe songs or something that's letting you know that this is not your person. Okay, but whatever it is, this is a feminine energy that's like in denial about this. And someone's very guarded against this person because it's like this person is, they act childish, but they also have like a hot temper. They're kind of aggressive with it, you know, whatever that is for you, but there's somebody here that is like all these. It's a combination of like the worst shit a person could have. It's like they're guarded, they have a hot temper, and they act like a kid. It's just like a fucking trifecta of shit. So that's a lot of stuff that needs to get worked out because nobody wants to deal with a kid when you're an adult. Nobody wants to deal with an asshole if you're nice. And if you're guarded, it's gonna be hard to allow people to love you when you're pushing everybody away. So you might want to work through these things for whoever this is. But yeah, so if you've been questioning if this is my karmic partner, you know, ask yourself when you're old and y'all can't have sex no more, you know, you're not really mobile, your kids done moved out the house and you're stuck alone with this fucking person. Is this the person that you want to die with? Like, can you see yourself sitting there and just enjoying that person alone with nobody else there? And if your answer is no, definitely get the fuck out, because that's not your person. You know, your person is the person that you're like, yes, you know, I can see myself being 80 years old, sitting in a rocking chair and just laughing and bullshitting with this individual. You know, that's good. When you have kids, it's a different type of dynamic because you're focused on the kids. You're focused on creating good humans. So it's a distraction from your relationship. You know, maybe you have some time for it, but a lot of your energy goes to your children. So see where you're at with that, and, you know, it might help you clarify who's your karmic partner. But whoever this individual is, again, they're showing me very childish behavior. Like, they play games, like, they make it, it makes it hard for you to actually build with them because they're always playing games. They're probably in and out, you know, they probably let you start the conversations or talk to them first or whatever and kind of see how things are going to go from there. So whatever that is, you know, and they might take, if you say, you complain about it or you say something about their behavior or something you don't like that they're doing, they kind of just play it down like, oh, it's not that serious, or, oh, that's just you, blah, 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 like they're not doing anything wrong, when in really they are acting like a kid. It's like, you know, get your shit together. You're either going to do this or you're not going to do this. Either way, let me know so I can move on with my life. It's that type of thing, you know, so just, you know, like I said, they're saying it's a karmic partner, so you already know what it is. And again, they have, I swear this is almost the same message from the first fucking message. Somebody's really stuck in their heads, like Nine of Swords energy. And again, we have internet, like somebody has a fake profile, they have something online, maybe even have access to your phone, or they have spyware on your phone, whatever that is, but this is what's going on right now. And there might be some type of conversation or something happening here that they're trying to get you to agree to, or they want you to do something. And whatever it is, this person is not sure about their feelings anymore. And whatever decision they made in the past, they feel like it was, with the knowledge they have now, they would have done something different. But I guess whatever has been done is done. You know, whatever you guys have going on. Oh, I'm sorry, Eknel. I have to see who's downstairs to do that. Because if not, I have to pause, yeah. Hang on one second. Sorry about that. Okay, so we have Sagittarius energy coming out here. And again, so whatever's going on here, there is some type of, and again, it doesn't have to be Sagittarius, just fire energy that's coming out here right now. And for some of you, there's a lot of concentration that needs to grow. Excuse me. There's a lot of focus on what you're doing, okay? There's empowerment that's coming through for you guys, and some type of activation. So you guys might be receiving activations at this time, and it might be happening while you're sleeping or in your dream state, and you're not fully aware of this, but there's going to be some type of surprise, something sudden that's going to catch you off guard, okay? And it might not be, it might be a little bit outside the norm, whatever it is, but there is there's something that's coming up for you, and it might be, it has something to do with you being free. But they're showing that you guys have luck on your side. And again, traveling's coming up for whoever it is that's going to be doing stuff. You know, the weather is getting nicer, but please stay open-minded. And somebody might be even very outspoken and very blunt, like almost tactless. Okay. So you know who you're dealing with this individual. But again, they're saying there's a decision that needs to be made in order for transformation to take place. Hi, Janine, how are you? So it's important for you to decide what's going to be your best course of action, okay? You know, what's going to get you to where you want to go, whether it's in personal life or if it's business life. You know, if it's business life, how are you going to get these things going to generate income for your business? You know, what are you going to do to get this going? And if it's just regular life, you know, what do you feel is going to make you happiest? You know, sit with yourself and say, okay, these things make me happy, these things make me miserable. Is this being provided by my partner? Is it not being provided? You know, see where you're at, because you can be happy by yourself. You don't want somebody to come and take away from your happiness. You want someone that's going to add to it. So see how that works for you. And we have here, like I said, the transformation. So whatever blocks you have, you know, you have to work through those. And you have to do things different, because literally it's everybody wants a different result, but nobody wants to do the work to be different, to change or transform whatever they have going on. So you have to see where you're at in that, because that's the only way you're going to break through. So if you're a person that finds like you procrastinate, then it's more of a, okay, I'm just going to get up and start doing it, as opposed to thinking about it. Because if you think about it, you're going to talk yourself right out of it. There was a book that I read, The 5-Second Rule. Literally, she says the whole book, but the gist of it is, you don't something you don't want to do, you count from 5 down like a fucking rocket ship all the way to 1, and then once you get to 1, you move. You just get up and you have some type of action, okay? And that's what you keep doing until you get used to getting out of the bad habits of procrastinating and not wanting to do shit, you know, because we all don't want to do anything. You know, there's days when you're like, I don't give a fuck, I don't want to do it. That's not life. You know, there's a lot of shit that we have to do that we don't want to do. So that's how you do it. Just count down and it's like, all right, I'm fucking going. Fuck it. Don't even give yourself the time to think. And if 5 seconds is too much, then go to 3 seconds. Okay. Enough time so you don't talk yourself out of it. Now, money's coming up here. And for some of you, you have to be welcoming the abundance to come in and create a better relationship with it, okay? Because money is energy, okay? It's a flow. So you have to build a good relationship with it. And some of you need to start finding some type of profit if it is business for you. So be happy with whatever opportunities are presenting themselves and the experiences that are coming in with it, okay? That's going to help you out a lot. Excuse me. And again, they want you to have your freedom. They want you to choose your freedom, okay? They want you to be independent. So if you're somebody that has been dependent on other people, dependent for many other things, you have to do the work to change this. You have to stand on your own 2 feet, okay? They want you to honor your feminine energy and the inner beauty that you have, all right? You have to love every part of you. And free yourself from whatever it is you feel is holding you back. Whatever you feel is holding you here, free yourself from that, okay? Especially if this type of energy that just kind of makes you feel bad and makes you feel like everything is your fault and they want to play games with you all the time. Don't do that to yourself, okay? Because that's definitely a karmic partner just by the behavior. Just don't do that. Now, again, there's somebody that might be coming in for you. Janie, I know I'd be doing the same thing. But for me, it's just, I'm anxious. So it's like, in my mind, I get overwhelmed with all of the shit. And I'm like, okay, this is too much. I can't do this right now. So you might start, you know, whoever this is, there's going to be some flirting, some playful energy with this. Okay. And it might be coming up because there's things that need to be healed from your past. Okay. Maybe you didn't really know how to. You didn't have good examples as to what a healthy relationship is or how to maintain one or what healthy love is. So these are things that you probably have to work through and verbalize your love. You know, if you haven't expressed it, if you, you know, just kept it to yourself, it's important for you to speak on it and, you know, let somebody know. But in doing this, you have to also be okay with possible rejection or just nobody saying anything. You have to be comfortable and confident enough in your truth to just be like, okay, well, this is how I feel. It doesn't matter if you feel this way because I still feel the same way, regardless if it's reciprocated or not. All right, so that's for some of you. All right, and like I said, if you're dealing with someone new, then that's awesome. And what you want in any relationship, I don't give a fuck, friend, family, spouse, whatever, you want to be free to be you. Authentically you, 100% you. You don't want to hide parts of you. You don't want to pretend to be something that you're not, because the shit's going to get old, you're going to get tired, and you're going to be like, you know what, fuck you, I'm tired of this, I'm tired of you, I'm tired of everything. So you want someone that you feel safe with, that you are free to be you. Like, you don't feel forced to fit into a fucking box that somebody has set out, like, oh, well, I want this, this, and this, and you have to be this, this, and this. because then maybe they're not your person. That's it. Just, okay, well, I'm not this, this, and this. I'm all of this. And if you can't deal with all of this, then go to somebody else. Okay, that's really what it is. So it's important for you to do that, okay? Because that's the only way you're going to be truly free and you're going to be truly happy. Hiding parts of yourself will always have you feeling miserable and your soul will be crying to be set free. And whatever's ending, again, with every ending, there's a beginning, okay? Just like the end of a chapter of a book, you turn the page, there's a whole new chapter, you know, that's life. Accept it and look at it like that. Don't look at it as, oh, this is ending, it's the end of the world, my whole life is turned to shit. No. Look at it as, oh, I get to go on a new adventure. This is a new challenge. You know, I get to experience new things, new people. Be excited about it. Don't feel so stuck in whatever is ending. Whatever is ending, let it end. Let it be done, because you already know what that chapter was. You've already been there. You've already done it. Go on to something new, because, again, they're saying clear out. You have to release whatever. That's okay. We have like three cards that came out that are literally saying you guys need to clear everything out. Okay. Even if it's in your house, clear out the clutter. If it's in your car, clear it out. Garage, wherever you have a bunch of shit that you don't use, you don't have any, whatever, get rid of it. Okay. And if it's people, start cutting cords, do the energy work, get rid of those people as well. But they're saying there's a lot of things that need to be released. And like I said, when you're doing these cord cuttings and burn ceremonies and shit like that, do it with the waning moon. Okay, because then that's just taking it away. It's going away. Go on to the third reading. Let's see. And here we have an energy that is, again, we have some indecisiveness and some fearful energy coming out here. And they want you to be willing to take a leap of faith, okay? Because if you are not taking any steps and you're not making any movements, what's really going to change? You know, you can hope and wish and dream for forever, but are you putting action to your dreams and your hopes? Like, are you doing something to make it happen? Are you trying to fulfill it and create it in your life? Because what they're showing me here is there's somebody that feels like they're unlovable, okay? And that's a terrible place to be, you know, and a lot of this emotion has a lot to do with the things we've experienced and the way our upbringing was, you know. So whatever this is like, it's just, you know, it's a crappy feeling. It's a shitty ass feeling, you know, and you should always love yourself regardless if nobody else fucking loves you. You have to love you, okay? That's really what it boils down to. Fuck everybody else and you have to love you. Yeah, new beginnings are where it's at, man. Enjoy life, especially right now. Springtime, everything's new creation. That's all what's coming up right now. Okay, that makes sense why we have unlovable. Okay, so if you guys are dealing with somebody, you have a partner, and you know you guys are together, there is some superficiality to this, okay? It's more about appearances, okay? It's not about how they really feel. It's just, oh, well, this person makes me look good, or this person provides this money, or provides that, or whatever the hell it is. But there is someone that is lying. They're covering up their cheating. They're hiding it from you. They're trying to keep it from you. And they're doing this with, twisting the facts. It's like they're probably omitting little things, or they're lying or giving you statements that are not fully true to give you some type of confusion or make you believe something else. Okay, so there's some type of deception going on here, and it maybe has you feeling like you're crazy because every time you try to talk about it or bring it up, it gets twisted or turned around on you, and you feel like you're like, wait, what just happened? Like, what was going on? This is not real. But it's because they're trying to cover up what it is that they're doing, whether or not you're aware of it. And I'm gonna say that right now you're not aware of it, but I feel like you might become aware of it, and it's gonna be something that is like, it's gonna be a tower moment for you. You know, it's gonna catch you off guard. You're gonna be shocked by this. And some of you might turn to self-medication, or this is something that has happened and that's where you're at right now, is self-medicating. And again, I don't recommend, just because it's not healthy. Try to replace it with a healthier habit, with, you know, try meditation, taking walks, anything that'll not poison your body. Okay, and whatever it is, again, for some of you, like I said, this is either happening, has already happened, or is going to happen between now and the next couple months. But there's some type of not speaking going on here, and it's like almost self-sabotage. Like someone sabotaged themselves by doing this, and it's like they're gaining clarity. Whatever fight or drama that's going to come up, it's like whatever it is, there's going to be clarity given. All right, so just try to handle this in the most compassionate way possible. And I know it's hard, especially when people are doing shit to hurt your feelings and make you feel bad, and they're not giving any regard to you. I understand. But don't allow that to bring you out of character, you know. Feel your feelings naturally, honor them, but just try to remember, you know, everybody has their own programming and everybody has their own brokenness that they have to work through and deal with. And sometimes we are the people there that either are the catalyst for that, we help them in some way, or we're the ones that suffer through it because we're the ones that need the growth. You know, so don't look at it as it's a bad thing or it's a terrible thing, because that's not what it is. And for some of you, you guys might have a soulmate coming in that you may have been calling for. I'm sorry. And again, this person might be very sweet, very compassionate, very loving, and very giving to you, okay? And it's going to help you to achieve a higher state of mind, okay? A higher vibration. They're going to help you to get there. So just whoever this is, you know, try not to sabotage yourself when this does come in. And like I said, soulmates can be anybody. It could be friends, family, whatever. But if this is romantic, try not to sabotage it, okay? Especially when we get in the feelings of I'm unlovable, nobody cares about me, nobody wants me. You know, that's more of a us thing. You know, why do we feel that way? And more than likely, we feel that way because there's people from our past that treated us like straight shit, that rejected us, that lied to us, that cheated on us, that did everything under the fucking sun they could possibly do. And you couldn't understand why, because you were good. You did everything you were supposed to. So it's not a you thing, okay? Don't internalize it and don't make it a you thing. Even if it was from your childhood, understand, like, if you had young, my parents were young as shit. They were like fucking 15, 16 years old. So the type of love that I got was not like as aware as if I had a 40-year-old parent, you know? It's very different. So try to look at it as they had their own shit. They only had whatever they knew to give to me, you know? And at a teenager, you really think about what the fuck your level was, your level of knowledge when your parents had you. Like, look at where they were mentally and emotionally, and you'll see how it impacted you, but you'll understand why, because that's as far as they could go. That's all they knew, you know? That's probably what their parents taught them. So don't internalize all these things, because it's not you. It's just that's what people do. They project the shit that they've been through, what they have going on, onto them, you know, onto us. It just, that's what happens. And it's sad and it's fucked up. And I can sit here all day and tell you about my whole fucking life and you'd be like, oh my God. But when you start understanding this, then you realize that your love, you have to love you. You have to love that little child that didn't get the love. You have to love the person that was broken by all of these different people because they didn't have the love to give you. They were broken themselves. And that's where all of this comes from. It's everybody's just broken in different ways. And sadly, when we're broken, we hurt other people. And it's not intentional, I want to hurt you. It's just those are our coping mechanisms, you know? So if you don't take the time to get to know people and understand, well, this person copes by cheating. Well, why do they cope that way? What happened in your life that, you know, that's where you began to cope? Like, that's your self-medication. You know, everybody has their own form. You know, people turn to drugs. They turn to alcohol. Other people just go and cheat. They turn to sex. You know, food. It's whatever each person is, you know. So just take it how it is, you know. And like I said, we're all lovable. You just have to learn to love yourself and not hold on to what everybody else has put on you, okay? Because everybody else's shit is literally everybody else's shit. They just needed to make you feel bad so that they could feel better, okay? And it's sad that people do that, but that's really what happens. And whatever it is, there's a person that this individual, whatever words you spoke to them, if you spoke truth, if you spoke from your heart to this individual, your words stay in their mind. They don't forget about you. They're there, okay? It's still there. And they probably, if you guys aren't talking right now, they're not talking because they can't handle the truth. They can't handle your authenticity. They can't handle where you come from. All right. And, you know, I've had people literally have tell me they can't handle my mouth. Like, they're like, I can't deal with you. And I'm like, well, I don't know what to tell you. I'm not going to change me to make you feel better. If you can't handle me, you can't deal with me, please move along. Because you're not the one. I need a specific type of person to be able to handle and deal with me. Like, you have to be a strong-ass fucking person to deal with me. And that's what it is, you know. So be okay with letting go. Be okay with moving on. It's not a bad thing. It's good for you, okay? It helps you to see. It helps you to become enlightened. It helps you to do these things so that you can go on to what you're meant to do. excuse me. And again, for some of you, like I said, this is the beginning. So whatever it is that's ending, this is just the beginning of your life. I don't care how old you are. Spirit's saying that this is the start for you, okay? Do the work. Do what you need to do for you, because this is the beginning and you're gonna have an awesome life, because they're showing that they're just showing me so much luck and so many blessings that are gonna come in for you, okay? It's like just a lot of success, everything. It's like you're gonna be a magnet. What is it called? Like the Midas touch, everything touches turns to gold. It's something like that. That's what you guys have going on right now. All right, so whatever restrictions, obstacles you have, you know, they're there, they set up. They're there to, you know, kind of challenge us. That's all it is. It's a challenge. It's okay, well, what do I do? How can I get over this? How can I get past this? You know, when I get challenged, I pray. If I really don't have a solution, or I really don't like the solution I have, and I'm like, I need something else, spirit, within a couple days, it'll be popping my head like, oh shit, I could do it this way. Perfect. You know, those are your spirit guys. So when you have random moments of, oh my God, that's them. They're giving you what you're asked for. Just pay attention, okay? Don't just, oh, it's a coincidence. Oh, yeah, there we go. It's your spirits. They're trying to communicate with you. Okay, so again, whatever obstacles, whatever you have going on with you, it's temporary. It's not going to last, okay? You're going to be successful. And some of you, again, like I said, if you're online or you there's something that you do that you influence other people, okay? You share your stories, you share what it is that you have within you with other people, okay? And I say this so much because I shared my stories with you guys. Some of you that have been with me for a while probably know. Others of you that are new probably never seen the videos. But I shared them because they were things that were hard for me to go through and things that I never spoke about because I felt ashamed or embarrassed by it. You know, and it gives other people that have been through the same thing or similar things hope that they can get out of it, that they can make it through this, you know. So believe me, sharing your story is not a bad thing, all right, regardless of how you feel, because it will empower somebody else. And even that, it may help somebody else gain a different perspective or a different understanding, especially if they are the type of that the abuser or the person that does those things to people. They might be like, oh my God, I can't believe I made somebody feel that way. So share your stories, help other people, you know, inspire other people to do the things that they're afraid to do and speak about the things they're afraid to speak about. and again, as far as finances is coming up again, so for finances, you know, make a budget. I don't budget. I'm not going to sit here and lie. I don't. I just like, I either spend money or I don't spend money. So, and it's bad because I'll go a month without spending shit. And then when I do buy shit, I'm spending a lot of money. I'm like, fuck. I'm like, why did I do that? I'm like, oh, I'm making up for the past month. No, that's not good. Don't budget that way. but yeah, you know, just really try to sit down, budget out whatever it is you're spending, whatever you need to buy. If it's for business, you know, obviously business and personal accounts, keep them separate. And just write down whatever it is. Like, okay, I need to buy this, this, and this. And this is how much I can afford to spend this month. So that way you know where your money's going and you're not blowing it, you know. And I know people do that a lot with eating out and things like that. So, and again, whatever it is that you're creating, regardless if it's a relationship, if it's business shit, be in alignment with who you truly are, all right? Don't try to be like every other person here, because that's not what we're here for. We're here to be our best selves. We're not here to be the best Bob or the best Jill. Jill is Jill, Bob is Bob, and you are you. That is how this works, okay? So you have to be in alignment with what's true to you, what your values are, what your morals are. Don't fold and don't bend for everybody else, even if nobody else fucking agrees with you. Eventually your tribe will find you. The right people will come to you. So don't bend for anybody else, okay? And align with the people that you would want to do business with, the people that will help you to advance. Align with those people and those energies. And again, we have dance coming out again. So I don't know if you guys are dancers or maybe you just love music like I love music. So just dance, you know, and enjoy life because that's all life is. Life is a dance, you know. Sometimes it's awesome. Other times it's like, hey, I don't like this experience so much. But, you know, we need the contrast. If we don't have the bad, how do we know when it's good? You know, how do we appreciate that? So look at it as this is not my favorite moment, but, you know, I'm going to go through it. We're going to make it through. We're going to work on it. Oh, Janine, it's never too... Girl, the stories that I've shared, I mean, there were probably too extra to share. So don't feel like your story is too extra and so fucked up because there might be somebody that needs to hear that because a lot of us have been through a lot of the same shit, like really surprisingly, and it's sad. And so many people are afraid to speak because they have this stigma and they make you feel bad, like, oh, you can't talk about this. That's taboo. And oh my God, don't do that. Just... if you feel that somebody needs to hear it and it helps to get it off your chest. It helps alleviate all that weight that you're carrying around. You have to let it out. You have to give it, okay? Have somebody that's willing to hold space for you and just let you process those emotions. You know, you can go through this. Don't feel like it's so fucked up, you know, because I've been through entirely too much in my life and I've shared a lot of it with you guys, you know. So don't feel that way. And whatever you understand, any possibilities that you guys have your standards. If you have standards, raise the fucking standards, make them higher, okay? Make people that are shitty people, make it difficult for them to access you, all right? So that way you're like, nah, these are my standards. If you can't meet my fucking minimum, you can keep fucking walking, all right? Save yourself a lot of time and energy, all right? So whatever expectations it is that you have, and maybe you haven't had them high enough, and even if they're expectations about yourself, you can do more than you believe you can. And this is, I've proved this to myself time and again when I'm just like, there's no fucking way, I can't do this. Like, I'm fucking exhausted. I'm ready to just say fuck everything. And somehow I get up and I go again. You'll find it within you. You just have to have that fire. You have to have that passion that drives. It's like, nah, fuck this. You're not winning. I'm not giving up. Don't do it, okay? And if you feel bound, you have to free yourself from whatever it is you feel is keeping you stuck. Naturally, if you got kids, obviously, no, not that route. You can't free yourself from them. They're yours. Keep them, raise them, do good. But if you're in a toxic relationship, if you're in a fucking job you hate, whatever it is that you feel is making you stuck, free yourself from it, you know? And for some of you, you know, once you become freed from this, you're going to fall into something better. So if you're in a toxic relationship, you're going to end up in a better relationship. You just have to allow yourself to explore these feelings because you might end up married to this individual. And for others of you, you might just need to release the marriage that you're currently in. And some of you, if you're currently married, you know, and you guys kind of been on the outs, just, you know, try to rekindle it if it's something you want to salvage, if you want to keep it, if you want to have it. You know, try to do that. So, yeah. And as, like, they're saying, like, with you, when you are aware that you create your world, that you're doing this, you start changing, okay? You start changing the things that you're focusing on. You start changing your mind and you start creating what you do want in your life, all right? So don't focus on the negative. Don't focus on the toxic. Because what's inevitable, what's here, what's happening right now, we can't change it. So this is what it is, and we have to find a way to deal with it. So you take it as it is, and you're like, okay, in this moment, this is happening, whether it's good or bad, you take it and you go with it. All right, but everything else, it's your projection, it's your perception. Your mind is like the film. That's what it is. It's like everything that you have in here is being projected out. So whatever you're seeing, it's what you have inside. And again, whatever, make sure that you guys are taking, and I have freedom again. So I just laugh because a lot of this is just free yourself, be free, let go, take care of your health. All right. Again, make sure you're drinking enough water. I know I don't do that. You know, you're getting exercise, even if it's taking a fucking walk, a hike, whatever it is. Do whatever is good for you that you're capable of physically doing without hurting yourself. Stay healthy. Get yourself together. All right? And like I said, they're telling you to free yourself. You have a choice. You always have a choice. Don't let anybody tell you you don't have a choice. If they say, do this or I'm gonna kill you, you still have a fucking choice. It's, nah, fuck you. You're just gonna have to kill me. So don't feel like there's always a choice. You might not like the options you have to choose from, but there's always a choice. And this is what's important with having judgments about people and the things that they've done and the actions that they've taken, is you don't know what choices this person had. You know, maybe they just had two really shitty options and they just did what the best thing they could do to survive. You know, this is why I tell it's important to have these conversations with people and see how they function. But yeah, whatever it is that you have going on, there is a resolution that's coming about. So don't feel pressed. Don't feel like it's never going to end or it's never going to work out. It's happening, and allow it to happen. Spirit's making it happen for you. So, like I said, we all have free will. If you choose to stay stuck, that is still a choice. You're choosing not to move. You're choosing to continue the life and the path and everything that you've already been on, that you already know what has you've gotten from it. You already know there ain't shit there. So try something else. Do something else. Those are the readings. I'm gonna pull cards for self-care for today. Yeah, no, I love music. Like, ever since I was a little girl, like, Dirty Dancing was my shit. Watch it a million times over. Even now, I put that shit on for my kids. They just be like, "Mom." I'm like, "What? I'm like, this is a classic. What do you mean? Patrick Swayze, what?" Up, here we go. Again, we have Sync with the Moon. All right. So for some of you, it's just, yes, Jennifer, Dirty Dancing. Nobody puts baby in the corner. From there on, that's my whole shit. Sync with the Moon, you know, for some of you guys just might be starting your cycle. Exactly. So you guys just might be starting your cycles. And like I said, when you're syncing with the moon, it's more of seeing what works for you, how your energy levels are, and you're basically becoming more in tune with yourself when you get this card. It's just do the moon phases. They're trying to see. I have a journal somewhere. I'm gonna try to find it and I'll show you guys tomorrow what it is so you guys can see. But there's a journal that has like the moon phases, so you're able to write in it. Now we have connect with crystals. And we have movement. So yoga, exercise, dancing, whatever you like doing. You know, for me, I could dance forever, but if you tell me to go fucking exercise for an hour, I was like, ugh, I can't do that. I don't know. But dancing, I could dance for forever. Well, I used to. I haven't done it in a while since I got hurt. I'm kind of scared. Scared of getting hurt again. All right, I'm gonna pull some crystal cards for you guys now. Let's see what comes out. Lapis lazuli, make a decision. They seem to be on point with the readings. They like, get your shit together, stop playing. We have pyrite. Let the money flow in. Okay, so if you guys are feeling really holding on to money or you're blocking it, stop it. Allow the flow. Don't resist. Be open to what's coming. And then we have adventuring. Create your own luck. All right, don't feel like it's outside of you. Change your mindset and you'll be amazed at what you attract. And like I said, affirmations. Whatever, even if you're fucking cleaning the house, you put on affirmations in the background and put your music on, you're gonna still hear the affirmations. So put it on, have the shit playing as much as you possibly can because it's gonna help you. I'm gonna pull answer cards. You guys focus on a question. I'm gonna pull three cards and you decide if you want number one, number two, or number three to be the answer to your question. We have big happy changes if you chose the first one. Oh, too many. All right. And we have in the near future if you chose the second one. And we have improving health. Okay, so whoever this is, whatever you have going on health-wise, make sure you're paying attention to it. And if you feel off, even if the doctors are telling you everything's fine, you know your body. Go and harass the fuck out of every doctor, every specialist, whatever it is that you need to do. Okay, so that way you can get better. So yeah, those are your readings for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you gained something from this. I love you guys. I hope you guys have an awesome day, and I'll talk to y'all later.